My father and mother actually cried to the day. Paddy was killed in 74. My father died in 76. And my mother died in 78. And my other brother Barney, his nerves failed after too. So it wrecked our house. Emptied our house out. My name's Michael Micklehone from Pomeroy, Limehill, Pomeroy. There's four of a family in our house. There was myself, Michael, Barney, and Paddy that was killed, and my sister Mary. Hadn't much, had a wee small bit of land and that there, and was happy with the had. Lived on the old way, the luck of hens and the eggs and milk of cow and whatever. Your own spuds and everything, you know. Happy. Hadn't much, but they're content and happy. Paddy was the child of the house. Paddy was a modest, good fella, a respectable fella, minded his own business and never done nobody any harm. And Paddy was very, very interested in music. So he joined Pomeroy Accordion Band when he was very young. He loved the accordion very much. He would go down to the lower room and he learned how to play reels and jigs and all. 7th of August 1974, I left that morning to go to my work as usual. I worked at the building a bit back and forward, and I was building a septic tank and finished that evening about 6 o'clock, and I come home and Paddy was on the evening before about mowing a field of hay. And I come home and I seen the hay mowed and I says to myself, Paddy will be happy now with this done. So I come on ahead down the road and I seen an awful pile of soldiers lying along the ditch with their rifles pointed into the field. And I passed no remarks. So I come on ahead down, turned into the house where I lived, the old house. And this soldier come out and he says, where are you going? Says, I'm going in there. He says to me, in a very vulgar way, you can't go in there. And I says, I live in there. Well, he says, get in. He says, and don't, he used the word F, don't F and we'll come out again. So I drive in on the street. And as I drive on the street, my father come out to the doorstep, and I knew to look at my father, something wrong. He come running over to me and he says, Mickey, Paddy's after been shot. I says to my father, sure, he's not dead. He's dead, he says, Mickey, for he never moved. So I got out of the car and I headed out to the road, to the meadow where my father said Paddy was shot. And I headed out to the road anyway, and this soldier run at me and hit me an awful crack on the chest with a rifle. And he said to me, he says, I thought I told you to stay in and don't come out. If you move another inch, he says, I'll blow the chest out of you. So I turned back into the house again. I went into the house. My mother was in the house and she had the teapot boiling on the wee gas cooker. I says to her, you may turn that teapot off. Oh no, she says, Paddy will be back in for his tea. Well, my father already told me that time what happened, but my mother didn't know. He didn't tell her. Didn't want to upset her. So my father took me down to the lower room and he told me the whole thing. And says I, what are we going to do? So my mother will have to know it. No, he says, just leave, wait till the priest comes. So the priest landed in between times anyway. And he says to me, Mickey, have you a white sheet in the house? Well, says I, there's a sheet anyway of some sort in. Says I, but says I, father, my mother doesn't know it yet. Says I, you have to tell her. So he told her, and it was a terrible howling to hear her crying. And me and Father McGill went down and put a white sheet over Paddy. And with the white sheet over him, said local prayers, and the helicopter swung right round and landed right down beside Paddy's body. This man got out of the suitcase, an army doctor. They examined Paddy up the back, opened his clothes up the back. He turned him over and he opened his chest on down. And as he opened his chest down, just right between his chest bone, the blood was oozing out of his chest. And he looked at him and he pulled the clothes up on him again. That's it, the way he went. So next come was the ambulance and the stretcher. Paddy was took away and that was the end of Paddy.
Paddy was my youngest brother and a great brother to have, and he was very kind to my father and mother. He looked after them very well. But I'll never forget the evening that I went up to Laham Hill that Paddy was shot. It was the worst evening of my life, I'll say. My poor mother and father, it was the finish of them.
It wasn't easy getting up to the funeral or nothing. The soldiers were very awkward and left it very hard for people to get to the funeral or anything, or get to the wake. They did die. And after the shot party, they threw all the turf into the bog, holding the cheer about right in the middle. The soldiers cheered. A Welsh regiment, the Welsh Guards they called them. Corporal Alan Jones was the man that shot him. Lance Corporal Alan Jones. He was the boy that tiptoed and pursued him and abused him first. Pulled the herd of him for my father seen it. And even in the shot party, my father ran over to him and asked him why they do that. There's a soldier turned around, hit my father with the butt of the rifle and tumbled him on the road. So, Paddy, that was the end of Paddy. Paddy was stuck away. A good lad, worked hard at home, never done nobody any harm. A decent good fella, never was involved in any troubles. Never was involved with anybody that was in troubles. Nothing wrong to do. He was a good lad and missed. But he was a big blow to the house. A big blow. And it's not altogether what Paddy's death was seen and everything, but there's after things there's never seen. The annoyance it created, and my brother too, Barney never was right after it. Father Barney, he came out and made a wooden cross very nice and put in. And it was in about a month or 6 weeks and we got lying one morning on the road, broke into pieces. Oh, I would have had an idea who was on the road that time, the night before, or 2 nights before, you know. Even when he's dead, they couldn't leave him alone, is right. No, they couldn't. Smashed the cross on the road. Oh, it wasn't easy. My father and mother cried to the dead. The first Christmas was Dara. Cried from morning to... morning to night. I stayed at home and had a look about them. Simply couldn't do, lad. Oh, Paddy was no threat or no door to nobody. Good lad, well reared. Good decent fella. The reason what the judge said, but until the army be in the hostile area, is justified to do what he done. And they cheered even on the left. They cheered. He's still classed as a terrorist, a good innocent fella that never done anything wrong. There's no justice for him. We never got justice yet for Paddy. And there's 15 of a regiment, and they all lay with their guns pointed on him. Even for hours after it, and him lying dead.
I'm learning how to live without you, and I never thought I could, and even how to smile again, I never thought I would. And to cherish the heart's memories that can bring you back to life, though some caress me gently and some cut me like a knife. But your light still shines, it's one small star to guide me and to help me hold back the dark. Your light still shining in my heart. Can your soul be out there somewhere beyond the infinity? I guess you found some answers now. I'll have to wait for mine till my light joins with yours one day to shine through time and space, and one day fall in the distant age upon some stranger's face. But your light still shines, it's one small star to guide.